Yeah.
Look at this picture of a shot of a girl. She comes to class. She says, I can't take the test. I don't have a babysitter, right? And I'm so balanced and happy and gleeful. I said, I can't let you be unhappy because I'm too happy for you to be unhappy. Why don't you bring that baby into class? Shh, we won't tell anybody. And you take your test, right? And that baby, I got to hold that baby. That's a cute ass baby. So, what I realized then is the power structure of a classroom is very imbalanced, right? A teacher is in charge and students are not, right? We control the grades, we control the curriculum. I didn't find that to be too fair now that I'm balanced. 10 years ago, I certainly did. So I realized teachers who are grumpy and imbalanced and angry, they focus on all of the superficial stuff. They focus on the margins and they get really pissed if the margin's too big, right? What they don't realize is how many students are living in those margins. And they focus on the paper and the surface level problems. They don't realize there's a whole person behind that paper. So I started changing my assignments. I write a letter now to students and I tell them about some of my life challenges. They write a letter back to me. And the things I hear are shocking, surprising. After losing our home, we jumped from house to house, and at some point, we lived in our truck. I still remember the day cops came to my house to arrest my father in front of me. I was in the third grade. I did my first line of meth at 16 and continued to use until the age of 24 before I went to prison for 5 years. These are not comments and quotes that I spent 17 years looking for and finally found three. This is my current semester class, right now. I just pulled out a few quotes that I found to be surprising. Now once, if I'm a balanced person and students are telling me these things, like I feel that weight. It's heavy on my heart, and so I'm imbalanced now. And I see that in the class, and now I've got to work to find ways to empower those students, to make them feel better about where they're going. And even if you're not a teacher, if you have personal balance in your life, you can see imbalances outside of your life. This is my family. We're a cute family, we're good looking people, thank you very much. And you know, I remember sitting at a restaurant after I came from a yoga writing retreat, and I'm enjoying the company of my family, and we're eating and laughing. And about three tables away from me was this elderly man sitting by himself eating fish and chips. And I remember how weak he was trying to get the attention of the waitress, and he couldn't. And I had felt so much balance in my personal life that when I saw that guy, I just felt so emotionally like saddened, right? And I felt his hopelessness, I felt his loneliness, I felt his sadness. I felt like I had to do something about it. So I just called the waitress over, and I said, our family wants to pay for that guy's meal, right? Small little gesture, I think it cost me $14, right? And I was like kind of choked up, and my daughter says, Dad, why are you crying? Until I cry a lot. His wife and I said, sweetie, I don't know. I just know we're a family of superheroes, and our job is to fix imbalances in the world. And that's what I felt like I did. And then as we were leaving, the waitress says, that was really sweet of you. I said, thanks. And she said, that man's wife died a month ago. And they used to always come in here together. And I said, I was glad I paid for friendships require balance as well. I have the pleasure of many, many, many friends. But when we call our friends, sometimes they say they're busy. And what I want to tell those friends is, if you're too busy for friends, you're leading a terrible life. I call my school friends and they say, I got work to do, I've got to work on my online classes, I've got to prep, I've got to grade, I've got to do all these things, I've got meetings to go to. And my response is always cynical and dark. And I say this, look, man, you're gonna die someday. Okay, and on your deathbed, you are not going to say, I wish I just sent one more email. I wish I could have gone to one more department meeting. If only I could have got my YouTube video just right for my students, right? You're not going to say that. You're going to say, I wish I spent more time with my friends, and I wish I could have created memories with those friends and never regretted a day with those friends. Same is true for kids. If you have balance in your life and you can see the imbalances in the world around you, you will notice in your kid's eyes when he wants to play chess with you, when your daughter wants help with homework, you will recognize these kids need you. And if you're self-absorbed all the time and all of your problems are kind of your problems and everybody needs to get the hell out of your way, you will never see that your kids need you, they need to spend time with you. And Like, you're not attuned to that unless you have your own balance of life. So I have three awesome kids. I feel like they have a pretty good dad. Same is true with marriage, man. Marriage, the definition of marriage is balance. If she cooks dinner, you better do the damn dishes. And when you come home and you're all happy and balanced, you can see, are you applying? You can see in her eyes that she needs some help and she needs some support. And if you're self-absorbed and imbalanced, you're not gonna see that. And lastly, attitude takes balance. We live in Modesto, California, the auto theft, meth, murder capital of the world, right?
Hoorah.
On paper, hoorah! On paper, we are a disaster. We're one of the least educated cities in the country, right? And so you can lean on that. You can be totally imbalanced and go, oh, our town sucks and everything sucks. Or you can realize that's not the whole story. That's just half the story. The other half of the story is we have tremendous culture and art here. We have a beautiful gala center. We have sellout poetry slams. We have a symphony. We have opera. We have tons of dance and music that comes out of every restaurant in town. We have all these car shows. We have famous alum like George Lucas who went here, Jeremy Renner. Like, there is good stuff, but you have to have balance in your life in order to see that. So my final message to you is quite simple. When we find our own balance, we begin to see imbalances in the world. And that's when we begin to make those changes. So I implore you, I